This is Generation Stadia, giving you that daily dose of everything and anything Stadia related, and today we have some news to cover. It sounds like we're going to be getting quite a few significant features coming to the platform in the coming months. That said, before we get into that, I actually want to quickly discuss one thing that I thought was pretty awesome. In the latest Destiny Community Podcast, episode 190, they recently had a Riot employee during their session. And before you get too excited, no, this has nothing to do with a game like Valorant or League of Legends Wild Rift coming to Stadia. But what I did think was interesting is that he chooses Stadia as his main platform to play Destiny 2. It's something that not only surprised me, but seemed to have surprised many of the people on the podcast itself. Now, I'll put a link with the timestamp directly to that conversation in the description below, but I'll give you a quick rundown on some highlights. He brings up how welcoming the Destiny community is over on Stadia, as well as highlights some very big gameplay differences when compared to other platforms. This is due to how multiplayer matchmaking is handled on Stadia, since everyone's technically playing on one server. It prevents those issues where you kill someone and then a split second later you get killed by lag. On top of that, another thing that gets discussed on the podcast is the lack of players dropping out to random connection errors. I have to say, it's quite nice to hear Stadia being talked about positively on that podcast, since before this, they were quite negative on the experience they had when playing Destiny 2 on it. But now let's focus on the news, and that's coming from 9to5 Google. Their latest APK insight found some very interesting things in the background in the latest Stadia app update. One of the biggest things seems to be this experimental feature where you're going to be able to opt in to try out new features that are still being worked on. And why may this be such a big deal? Well, it also shows that there may be a way to play Stadia on any Android device. They found a string of text that says the following: "Mobile gameplay on this device is in development. Using this feature may affect game performance and can be turned off at any time." Hopefully this means exactly what it sounds like, and soon we'll be allowed to play Stadia on any Android device despite not being officially supported yet. There's always been the workaround of running the Chromium APK in desktop mode, but honestly, it's not as smooth or nice to use as the official Stadia app. Another really neat feature that seems to be in the works is touch controls, and this is the second time we're hearing about it. It seems Google's getting ready to gear up for you to be able to play on your phone without the need for a gamepad of any kind. I personally think it's fantastic that Google is adding this feature in. Now, I'm not much of a touchscreen gamer, I've never really used my phone to play video games all that much without a controller to pair it with, but I know that there are plenty of you out there who do prefer gaming on a touchscreen. I also can't deny just how convenient it is to not have to lug around a controller with you if you want to play on Stadia, and I'll probably end up using the feature myself to play certain slower paced games. But the thing worth mentioning more than just an on-screen gamepad is that certain games that are actually built in mind with touchscreen controls seem to have their own unique way of implementing those touchscreen controls on Stadia. Next on the list is Party Chat, something that isn't currently available on Android phones despite being accessible through the Chromecast or Chrome web browser. This is one of those things where I would qualify it as a basic feature that really should have been in there at launch, but either way, it's great to see it happening now. I do think it's extremely important to have feature parity across Stadia, so no matter which way you decide to play, you can have a very similar experience. Aside from just adding Party Chat to Android devices though, it does seem that they're also doing some overall work in the party system as a whole, including its UI. But now let's put our focus on what's most important here, because they seem to have found some strings related to demos, free trials, and free weekends. From the very start, I couldn't speak enough about just how important it would be to have a demo system set up for people to try out their favorite games on Stadia. And while they've already done a free trial of Stadia Pro, it is a completely different thing to allow people to choose what type of game they want to play. I'm really hoping that this is the start of what I'm talking about. Back in the day, OnLive had a system set up where you could demo any game for 15 minutes. It was a really good representation of what you could expect if you invested in the platform, and Stadia could really use something similar here. The technology since back in the day has improved tenfold, and Stadia really can provide a phenomenal experience for most users. And there's no better way to entice new users than by offering them a free trial of the game they're looking forward to most, or what they're used to playing already. While Stadia Pro is offering a really great selection of games right now, it's definitely not for everyone, and some people just have no interest in those titles. Letting people choose and pick what game they try Stadia out with definitely will convince quite a few new users, I'm sure of it. But aside from that, the other really neat thing to see is that they're going to be incorporating free weekends, because we've already missed quite a few on the Stadia side of things, so hopefully we'll be introduced to them somewhat soon. But that pretty much summarizes everything I have to say. There are a few other little details such as upcoming sales, but nothing too significant. If you want to check out everything else that they found, be sure to check the description below for the link to 9to5 Google's article. Now, if you enjoyed this video or found it helpful at all, be sure to hit that like button, as it really does help the channel out. And if you're wanting more content like this, be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell as well. Today's end of video message is just gonna be a bit of an important channel update. I apologize for not uploading sooner this week, but it turns out that I'm having some serious problems with my ISP provider. The issue will be fixed, but it seems like it's gonna be slightly more complicated than just having a technician show up to the house. Basically, it affects my entire neighborhood, and the specialist has to come and track down where the issue lies exactly. So what type of effect will this have on my videos? Well, hopefully not too much. That said, if you start to see non-Stadia gameplay appear in the background of these videos, I do apologize, but it's simply because the internet connection I have right now is kinda going up and down, and sometimes it's just not sufficient enough to stream Stadia. Fingers crossed that this won't take too long to fix. In the meanwhile, I just wanted to give you all the heads up and a bit of an update on what's going on. If something big does show up on Stadia all of a sudden, then I'll do my best to try and find a local Wi-Fi spot that'll be sufficient enough for me to take my laptop and record there. Anyways, thank you for watching. This has been Generation Stadia, giving you that daily dose of everything and anything Stadia related. The Gen S community is over 4,100 strong and growing by the day, and until next time, I'll catch you in the clouds.